Hi everybody and welcome back to my backyard. Today, as always, is a rainy day and I wanted to go fly and I probably still will. And in fact, I finally printed a mount for the GoPro on the Flywoo Explorer LR. The first thing I want to tell you is this cable, the one that goes to the Beta FPV back, has to go all the way there where there is this capacitor, and it's a mess to solder it. But then it's pretty straightforward. I made this mount to fit on the screws on the top plate, and I feel like this mount, as always, I mean, it's mine, I am biased, but it's better because look at the center of gravity, it's super low, so you can kind of lock it like this, and still it swivels. You can take the SD card out really easy. And of course, this is the Dyson Mini V4 mount, and I only made this piece down here to fit the Explorer LR. And also, I have a mount like this for the Baby Croc from IHGLC. I'm butchering names today. And also, one thing I want to tell you, this mount is very, very thin. First of all, of course, for weight reduction, but also because I feel like a little bit of swivel on top makes it soft mounted. I tried it yesterday, it doesn't show any signs of jello, which is fine, so very, very good. Also, I printed it and cut the camera mount because we have the camera down here.
And also, before I go fly, I want to point out something about the GPS on here, because some people told me they are having issues with it, and yesterday I thought I was having issues too, but only you need to let it sit there, not arm it for like a couple of minutes. If it doesn't work, and then it will lock satellites. I mean, it's a little bit slow, but it works, trust me. Just let it sit on there and you will notice if it's working, because when you arm the drone, I mean, not when you arm, when you plug in your LiPo, it will flash green for a millisecond and then it doesn't flash never again. So if you think it doesn't work, check if it's blinking when you turn it on. And now I want to go to some cool place and try flying this drone and not losing it. I mean, the place where I live is full of creeks, so it's super easy to lose it. And even with the GPS, even with the buzzer, I mean, a creek is a creek. Goes down there is a river full of trees. Good luck finding it. So I found what looks like a pretty amazing place. Look at this.
We have an aqueduct right here. Then down there is a castle, city hall, and then down there is a church. I mean, this is not the best position right here, but still, I'm gonna try. And just look at this, like the complete moron I am. I forgot the 4S batteries, so I cannot fly. I gotta go back to my house, cause here I only have these puny little batteries. There you go, the worst way ever to put lipos, but still. Okay. Look at that. Boom. They fit nicely. I finally have all the batteries and stuff. I'm just waiting until it picks up some GPS and then I'll go and fly.
perfect. I just watched the video on my phone. The raw video not stabilized is not bad. I gotta say there is a little bit of shakiness, but I guess Rinsteady will clean that out. And also, it's kind of stable, I gotta say. All my other ones are super, super shaky. This one is almost as good. You will see the raw footage right now. And talking about performance, I don't know, but I feel like my Dyson X is a little bit better. I will try it. I mean, I will make another video. This is content. I will make another video comparing this to my Dyson X, because I feel like that does more, goes faster, and the VTX is better some way, because this is 450 milliwatts. The other one is 200 with a dipole antenna, super bad, but it's magic signal. It's perfect, crystal clear all the time. I don't know how it's possible. This one, I flew there, and when I was getting, you will see the DVR, when I was getting behind those buildings, I was getting a little bit crispy. Nothing too bad, I could still fly, but you know, I don't trust going further if I see some static, you know.
Also, today I was flying with a 650 milliamps 4S battery with the GoPro on top, and my first impression is it doesn't push a lot, and we already knew that it cruises very, very good, and it's made for that. It cruises at 50 kilometers per hour, really good. You can go 60 maybe, but if you go higher, it doesn't want to go. It doesn't want to go higher than that. And if you go slow, it sips on battery, but if you want to go faster, it's not that efficient. I feel like this drone is better, but this is material for another video. I mean, I want to compare both of them, the Dyson X with this one, because what's more efficient? 4-inch biblade on a heavier drone, or a drone that weighs about 80 grams less, but it has 3-inch on the same battery? I feel like this is more efficient, and also, look how small it is. And it just doesn't have GPS and stuff, so if you lose it, you lose it. And now I'm gonna leave you to the actual restated colored video, and hope you like it. I did my best. Probably knowing better this drone, I will push it more, and I'll see you at the end. And that's it for today. Probably I will add this to my backpack, because I mean, it works very good. I just have to know it a little bit better, but in some sketchy situation, having a GPS, it's very good. I mean, you have that extra peace of mind that something goes wrong, you can recover it. That's something I don't have with my Dyson X. But this one, I know it very, very well. And I mean, I flew very far and never lost it, so that's one. So if you like this video, please subscribe, leave a comment, and like this video. Also, if you didn't like, tell me why you didn't like it. I mean, everything helps. I need interaction. I need to push the algorithm and make this my main job, because that's what I want to do. I want to fly drones and have fun. Till next time, stay safe and happy flying. Bye.